There's Kareem, you know, and then there's a debate, you know, right. in terms of Jordan and LeBron. And on any given night, you know, who do you like? You know, for me, I look at, you know, the total body of work, what LeBron James is as a basketball player. And if I had to pick one over the other, right now I'm picking LeBron James over a Michael Jordan.
Woo, them's just fighting words in some neighborhoods. So we heard Isaiah Thomas choose LeBron over Michael Jordan. Scotty, been saving this topic for you. I'm so glad I'm here. I've been very excited about this. Do you agree with Zeke?
I don't agree with nothing Zeke ever said. I don't even agree with nothing he ever did.
Whoa. Oh, get him.
You know what? I find that comment there just hating, you mm-hmm. know? I've never seen this guy embrace or thank Michael Jordan for what he's done for the game, done for our league, done for all the kids out here in terms of basketball. Michael Jordan is the greatest player to ever put on shoes and play in our game. No doubt about it. I'm always asked about questions to compare him to LeBron. I try to make the best of it. I've tried to make the best of it, but really the comparison shouldn't ever be made. They both play two different positions. The way LeBron James play, Michael Jordan was never asked to play that way because I took that away from him. I was the point forward. I was the facilitator. Michael Jordan is a scorer. He was a defender. He played the game as complete as LeBron James did when he needed to, but he was asked to score the basketball, and that's what he was great at. And there's no game that I would ever play in and pick LeBron James over Michael Jordan.
No game.
No game.
So now you're just being
firm about
it.
Not if I'm trying to win. Not if I'm trying to win. I mean, I'm not going to give up my teammate who I won 6 championships with and go and start fishing in a pond thinking I'm going to catch a bigger and better fish.
I didn't mean to laugh while you were talking, but T-Mac had his Kermit the Frog behind you.
Hey, man, I'm just here for Scotty, man.
I want to hear what T-Mac has to say.
No, I mean, I disagree with Zeke. I think Jordan is the greatest of all time in my book. You know?
What makes him better as a basketball player? Not the rings argument. What makes him better as a basketball player, like Scotty just described? What makes him better to you?
For me, I think just completely just taking over games, you know, when it really counts. Not deferring to anybody at any given time. Yeah, there's times where he passed off to a John Paxson or, you know, a Steve Kerr. Yeah, but when it's time to get a bucket, I mean, MJ was that dude to take over a game, averaging 40 in the finals 1 year, winning that championship. I mean, defending the best players.
Exactly.
I can't. He's just the greatest to me, man.
Isaiah Thomas comment?
Doesn't take away from LeBron is awesome.
Yeah.
And right. Best in our era that I've seen. He's the best. But the GOAT?
And I can praise LeBron in a different way because people like T-Mac, guys that can score, would love to play with a guy like LeBron.
Absolutely.
Because they want the ball as well. But when you play with a guy like Michael, who's a superior scorer, and I played most of my career with him, and when you hear a guy come out the huddle and you see that he wants the ball and he's working for it night in and night out. You can't compare him to LeBron that guy. LeBron is not going to be the guy that say, I want this last shot.
Yeah,
get me the ball.
It's going back
like,
to.
I hear that from Michael. I've heard that from him. Like, no matter what the situation is, get me the ball.
Yeah.
And basically, that tells me, get him the ball or I'm calling timeout.
No, it's hard for me to look back, you know, in a few of those finals where LeBron just was a no-show. You look at the first championship run with Miami against that Dallas series. I mean, it's hard for me to get over that, how he performed in that. Now, he's learned over the years yes. of going back and being dominant, but, you know, to have those mishaps, I mean, MJ never had that in his championship.
Scott, you were talking during the break, though, about the physicality of LeBron James, his size, and you were saying what now, that you couldn't defend him if you played today?
Well, this is where I think LeBron James' greatness come in, and this is where I put him up there as one of the greatest players because of his physical gift to the game. He sort of brought the Michael, the Kobe, the Magic, the Scottie, He has all our body size. He has our speed. He has our athleticism. And he's been able to do that and play the game the right way from a statistical standpoint, getting rebounds, making everybody on the floor better. And he's also a great scorer. So that makes him great within himself and a guy that we've never seen play the game the way that he can, because he can dominate the game in a lot of areas as well.
Here's why. MJ is the GOAT in terms of basketball accomplishment, but the overall, you know, when we talk about social issues, LeBron James is the GOAT in that, you know, in that sense. He's the greatest to ever do it. Great on the basketball court, but also great in dealing with social and political issues and not being afraid to voice his opinion and being very articulate on those, where a lot of guys, you know, shy away from, you know, even coming out saying anything.
But people aren't using that as an argument for him over MJ. But you mentioned that you took sort of the ball handling away from him and some of the distributing. Do you think if you were not his teammate, if Michael Jordan had been not only the top scorer but the top distributor on his team, that he could have put up the same types of numbers? Obviously, he did have his share of triple-doubles as well.
He would have evolved a little bit more statistically like a LeBron James, but still, he would have been a better scorer than LeBron, I believe.
Last thing here, when you, because I saw the fire in your eyes there, when you saw Isaiah Thomas mentioning that, does it reignite any sort of feud? Still some bad blood there? How does that?
It's gonna be always bad blood there. That was something that he didn't allow to heal in time, and that time has now expired. So the bad blood will always be there.
It looks like it makes it personal in your mind when he makes opinions like these then?
Yeah, it does make it personal. And, you know, I think even looking back at the video when that situation happened, it became personal then.
Man, that's great stuff. And I can't believe I'm here to talk to you about it.